Hi, I'm Landlord, and today I'm going to be showing you how to draw a dragon headshot. I'm going to be using examples of Wings of Fire headshots. You can use this headshot to draw whatever type of dragon you like, if it's just a dragon you made up, or if it's a certain dragon you want to draw, or if you just want to try it out and practice. First, you're going to be starting by drawing a circle. So you know about how big your head is going to be and in which spot. Use a pencil to do these sketch lines because you're going to want to erase it later on, and have a pen to go through everything once you've got the right sketches. Once you've got that circle as a head, you can go over it many times to see, to try to get it right. But now we're going to flatten the head a bit. Go down and then make the snout. So just roughly draw a line to show how long the snout is. You can always make it longer or shorter. That's why we're using a pencil, so you can erase it if you think it needs to be longer or shorter or maybe higher up. And now we're going to draw some curvy lines to show the expression of the dragon. And draw the bottom of the snout and kind of like the jaw. I like to add this little thing. Some dragons have that kind of thing here, but you don't have to add it. Now we're going to start doing the neck. The neck, you're just going to go down like that. You can go like that, or you can just keep doing it in an arc. But I personally like it like that. And then you're going to cut it off because we're just going to draw the headshot and not the entire body. Here's a mini version of a type of dragon that I made up and I just drew on a sticky note. So when we're done, it looks something like that kind of shape. Now you're going to draw the horns. The horns, many dragons have different types of horns. Ice wings have slightly, like, very straight horns, like icicles. And sea wings sometimes have kind of curved horns. So you can really just choose any type of horns you want. I'm going to go with slightly curvy horns today, but not very curvy. Follow along how I make the horn shape. I like starting like this, so I know exactly how thick it's going to be and where it's going to start, and it just helps me with it. I should get something like that. You can make the horns bigger or smaller depending on the tribe you're making or how you want it to look like. Now we're going to get started on some of the details, some teeny tiny details in case you want to add any. Now, certain dragons have this kind of horn-like thing on their snout, so you can draw that if you want, depending on the tribe that you're drawing. You know, some dragons have this bigger horn on there. You can add that if you want to, but I'm gonna try to keep it as simple as I can. Next, next we're going to draw the lines of where the underbellies and the scales are, so we know where to put certain parts and we don't get confused. So you see this part, there are scales here. I added gills just for fun instead of scales, but there's that underbelly there, so we're gonna slightly separate it. I'm gonna separate it slightly at here. We'll show that the underbelly is slightly there. And follow that line. Alrighty. So, now once we're done that, we're gonna start doing, more things on the head, like the ears or the eyes. The ears, I made a tutorial if you're drawing on an art program on a computer or drawing iPad or tablet or that kind of thing. I heard some people use those. Then you can watch one of my videos on one of the types of styles that I like using to draw the eye. But for now, I'm just going to draw an eye shape, which will also show the expression. You can always move the eye or the eye shape if you think it should be in a different spot, or maybe you want to change the shape of it a bit, then you can do that just using a pencil. Alrighty, so now you're going to draw the ear. Now in this sticky note thingy, I actually forgot the ear. You might forget the ear on certain ones. Make sure you put that there. So just follow along how I'm doing the ear.
Right there, that's there. You can make bigger or smaller,
however you like, but I think that's a good size. Now we're going to start doing a little more details. So you're going to add these kind of lines dragons have on their underbelly. You don't have to add them. Certain people don't add them, but I usually add them because I think it makes it a little more realistic. And not exactly realistic, but look more like the dragons in the Guide to Pantala or Pyria or that kind of stuff. So you should get something like that. Now we're going to do scales. Now different dragons have different types of scales. For example, sea wings have gills instead of many scales, and also have stripes that light up on their underbellies, which you can also add that. I'm going to show many ways of doing scales here and some tricks and tips. So rain wings don't have much of a scale-like spots, but they have more of dots. So there would be like tiny dots going down like that. So you can add that if you want to, but I'm going to go more of an ice wing type scales and see how that works out. Because I think those are just really simple to draw because they're just slightly triangle-like spots. So first it helps if you draw a line. You could use a different color if you're drawing on a computer, because then you'll know. You could always erase it no matter what color or what kind of thing you're using. But if you're drawing on paper like I am showing, then just use a pencil, and you could just make it, maybe you can push down harder, I guess, or you can make it slightly lighter. But I'm just gonna keep it like this. Try to keep it simple.
can make those lines of how many scales you want in what places. So those are just the lines for the middle of the scales. So now I'm going to show what to do next and how to use these lines to make the scales easier. So you technically put a line diagonally-ish to where the line to where the base like lines are to help us with it, and do another the other way. And you're just gonna keep doing that down. Again, you can always like make those lines a different color if you want. Try not to press down exactly too hard because you want to erase that. So have a thin eraser by so you can erase it once we're done doing all of this. I totally forgot to mention that you're going to need an eraser, so go get an eraser. Alrighty, now you should get something like that. Now you can make different scales slightly thinner or larger or however you want. So here I'm gonna do slightly more diagonally scales and more closer together. You can line up the lines, you can do it however you want. Just make sure you're gonna keep it onto that base line. And you can do scales where you just do lines outward from these spots. So that is perfectly fine too. You can do that if you want. So here I'm showing many different ways to do the scales. And I'm going to show you how to do gills too. So this is rain wing type because there are those dot-like spots. And then sea wings have these gills, so you just do those triangle-like things with that line, but they're very wide and not very narrow. And you can just like make the line like that. Sea wing gills will look something like that. High wing scales, I'm not exactly going to show. They're kind of similar to ice wings. So are sand wings. They've got those similar types of scales. Let me see if I can think of any other dragon type scales that you can use. Now you can make up any type of scale you want. You can make up new types like polka dots or diamonds or anything you like. Nightwing scales aren't exactly triangles, but they're kind of like you do like a large plate like thing and then like that. So if you're drawing Nightwing scales, then they're probably gonna look something like that. Like, I'm not exactly done doing it all the way. Or you can do it in a different way to do Nightwing scales. You can just make these lines, not like lines to make these curvy shapes, and then in those tiny spots here, you can make them a little sharper so you know this one, and then you're gonna go like that. So you can do both those types of ways. have similar scales on the scales I showed. Nightwings have similar scales, I guess, to Mudwings, but Mudwings are more like big and plate-like scales, and they've actually got like kind of two colors changing, so it has a slightly different type of scale shape. You can check that out in my Mudwing headshot that's on Art Academy. So I'm using a Wii U like a device to draw it. So if you're drawing any of those tribes, you can check out my video specifically for those. And then let me show you how to do luminescent scales. So on the underbelly, they've got kind of like these circles which glow up, and on their cheeks kind of, or like under their eyes, I guess, there are these scales that you can copy what I'm doing here. Just like that, and those scales. Now you can leave the horns like you want, but you can add these tiny lines that there are on horns sometimes. You can make some triangles on the horn, or you can do like a whole bunch, or you can just do it normally like that, or just straight lines, however you want. So I'm gonna make one horn in a way and make the other in a different way, just so you can see certain ways. Here there are triangle-like ones. Now dragons don't really have those, but if you're just experimenting and you just see random dragons and you just type a dragon without wings of fire, then some dragons have this type of shape on their horns, but you can just leave the horns without those. I'm just saying certain dragons have those, and you can add them if you want to. So now you should get something like that. Alrighty. Now I'm going to go using a pen to go through all of this, and you're not going to do your sketch lines like the lines over here for the circle you did. So just follow along on certain parts that I do that I go over with pen. You don't have to press down so hard. You can take breaks if you want. If you press down really hard when you're doing the outlining, it might make a hole, so don't do that. But if you do it too lightly, you might still be able to see the pencil, so do it kind of in the middle. I'm going to do slightly the eye. I'm not exactly making the eye very, I'm not doing it very detailed eye. I'm just coloring it in. But if you do want to do a detailed eye, I'm going to put links in the description to all those types of separate parts that I make videos for.
don't do these lines. Don't do that line, but just do the triangle-y lines as the scales. Now you should get something like that, and you're going to erase the sketch lines that you made. So take an eraser and do that right now. You can just erase over everything because the eraser won't erase the pen. So you can just go over everything with the eraser and it'll only erase your pencil marks that you don't want. Now you should get something like that. You can color in this if you want to, but I'm not going to be showing this. I might make a separate video on dragon scale coloring, but I hope this tutorial helped you, and please like it if you want other people to find it more easily, and you think it was good, and stay for any more of my other video tutorials. If you want any special tutorials on certain things like the coloring or its types of scales, then please request that in the comments. If the comments work, sometimes when I upload it, it puts it on made for kids, which it is, I guess, but doesn't let you do comments. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and bye!